Hi there, I'm Callum Anderson, and I'm pleased to be here again at the Horniman Museum. And today I'm going to be playing on this late Georgian and early 19th century chamber organ. The first piece I'm going to play to you today is a work by the 18th century German composer Johann Caspar Ferdinand Fischer, who was a contemporary of J.S. Bach. And the work that I'm going to play by him is a chaconne in F major, which was written around 1738. And you'll notice that if you know the cantata Wachet auf by J.S. Bach, you'll notice that it's very similar to the opening of that cantata. So I'm sure that Bach knew this piece of music and took Fischer's work and used it as his own.
Thank you.
Next, I'm going to play two voluntaries by the English Renaissance composer Thomas Wilkes. Thomas Wilkes was at one point the organist of Chichester Cathedral, and he was best known for writing madrigals, but back then he was also a notorious alcoholic and drunkard and was dismissed but reinstated about three or four times from the cathedral, and I think would frequently turn up to the organ drunk and play. But luckily I'm not drunk today, so hopefully my playing will come across a bit better than his did. Thank you. The next piece I'm going to play is by the English composer Charles Wesley. It's a prelude and fugue in G minor. Charles Wesley lived from the end of the 18th century into the early 19th century. He was the son of the famous Charles Wesley Sr., who wrote many hymns and established Methodism in the United Kingdom. And Charles Wesley Jr. Was known as being a child prodigy. I think he started playing the organ around the age of three. This prelude and fugue was written around 1814, at the time when Charles Wesley was working for the Prince Regent. And his virtuosity is apparent when playing this piece, as it's quite a fiddly piece to play.
Thank you.
The next piece I'm going to play is Aria Sopra Spagnoletta by the Italian composer Bernardo Storace. We don't know very much about Bernardo Storace except that he existed in the year 1664 when he was mentioned as being the Vice Maestra di Cappella of the Messina Senate. And this piece, Aria Sopra Spagnoletta, is a set of six variations on a spagnoletta, which was a Spanish dance that developed in Italy in the early 17th century. Thank you. I'm now going to play another voluntary, this time in G major, by the 18th century English composer William Welland, who was the organist of Christ Church Cathedral in Oxford. And this voluntary is split into two sections, first a somber adagio section and then a more lively allegro section that follows it. Last piece I'm going to play to you is the Prelude and Fugue in F major by J.S. Bach from the second part of the well-tempered clavier. I thought that I would play this particular Prelude and Fugue in the organ, and I think it's particularly well suited as the instrument. The Prelude has a lot of sustained notes, and this is done very well on the organ compared to a harpsichord where the sound eventually dies away. So I hope you enjoy, and thank you to the Horniman Museum for having me here to play again.
Thank you.
So a chamber organ like this, which is generally much smaller than most church organs, it could have been found in a church, possibly to accompany a small group of singers. But it would most likely have been found in the homes of wealthy people who would have used this instrument for private recitals or as a rehearsal instrument for accompanying instrumentalists or singers. So first of all, I had to think about what this organ can do in terms of sound. So it's only got four stops and four different sounds. So you're quite limited in a certain repertoire that you can pick. It's only got one keyboard, and some organs have as many as four or five keyboards. So I had to pick repertoire that could be played on just one keyboard. And I also picked music from both Renaissance and Baroque periods. And I think music like that is well suited to an instrument like this. So there's a lever down here on the left-hand side of the organ, which you push down with your left foot, and that disengages this stop here, which is a 15th, and the principal on this side, and those go in, which diminishes the sound when you press that down. So an organ voluntary is a piece of music the organist usually plays before a service at church or after a service or possibly during communion to fill the time when everyone's receiving the bread and wine. And it literally just means, you know, the organist is volunteering to play a piece of music, hence why it's called a voluntary. So a chaconne is a piece of Baroque music. It's a type of dance. And what a chaconne is basically a chord sequence that is repeated over and over again. But the music is varied and changes using that chord sequence to give variation and variety to the music. So this organ, which we think is built at the end of the 18th century or possibly the early 19th century, isn't electric. So it has to be pumped by hand or foot, either by someone helping the organist or by the organist themselves. And that's what I've been doing today. And what I'm doing is that I'm pumping air into the bellows of the organ. And then that air is transferred to the pipes and therefore a sound is made through the pipes when air is blown through them. So big church organs, like this organ, would have been pumped by hand, but it wouldn't have taken the organist to do it. It would have had, well, depending on the size of the organ, it would have had several people pumping air into these huge bellows for these big organs, or possibly some poor child who would have been given a few pence for doing it.